Welcome to a lesson on solving one-step linear inequalities in one variable. The goals are to solve one-step linear inequalities and also to express the solutions as an inequality, a graph, and using interval notation. And to review, here are the three ways it will express our solutions. On the left, we have an interval expressed as an inequality. In the middle, we have the graph of the interval. And then on the right, we have the interval expressed using interval notation. Notice for x less than 2, we have an open point on 2, and then we shade to the left. And as we move to the left on the number line, we would approach negative infinity. And notice how this is why we have a negative infinity and positive 2 using interval notation. We always use a rounded parenthesis on positive or negative infinity, and then we use a rounded parenthesis on 2 because it's an open point. Notice for x is less than or equal to positive 3, we have a closed point on 3, and then we use a square bracket on 3 to show that value is included in the interval. For x greater than 0, open point on 0, arrow to the right, and then interval notation is from 0 to infinity, both with rounded parentheses. And for x is greater than or equal to negative 4, closed point on negative 4, and then shade to the right. And then using interval notation, we have a square bracket on negative 4, again showing that it includes the endpoint, and then infinity. Now the steps for solving an inequality are exactly the same as solving linear equations, except if we multiply or divide by a negative, when solving for the variable, we must reverse the inequality symbol. Now let's try to justify this extra rule. Here we have negative 2 is less than positive 4. We know this is true because negative numbers are always less than positive numbers. So if we divided both sides of this inequality by, let's say, negative 2, notice how it would give us the inequality positive 1 is less than negative 2. Well, a positive number is never less than a negative number, so this is not true. So to make this true, we'd have to reverse the inequality symbol. We would have 1 is greater than negative 2. So whenever multiplying or dividing by a negative, we must reverse the inequality symbol. Let's go ahead and take a look at our examples. Here we have x plus 4 is greater than or equal to 7. So to solve this for x, we need to subtract 4 on both sides of the inequality. We're not multiplying or dividing by a negative, so we don't reverse the inequality symbol. This would be 0, so we'd have x is greater than or equal to 7 minus 4 is equal to positive 3. So here's our solution expressed as an inequality. Now let's go ahead and graph this. So if this is 0, let's say 3 is here. Notice that 3 does satisfy this inequality and therefore is in this interval. So we make a closed point on 3. And then for numbers greater than 3, we have an arrow to the right. As we move right on the number line, we are going to approach positive infinity, which means for interval notation, we'll have 3 to infinity. It includes 3, so we'll use a square bracket. And then for infinity, we use a rounded parenthesis. So we've expressed the solution as an inequality, as a graph, and using interval notation. Looking at the second example, we have negative 2x is greater than positive 8. So these two are attached by multiplication. So to undo this multiplication, we'll divide both sides by negative 2. And since we're dividing by a negative, we do have to reverse the inequality symbol. So this would simplify to 1x, or just x. And then instead of greater than, it's going to be less than. And then 8 divided by negative 2 is negative 4. So here's our solution as an inequality. Let's go ahead and graph this. So if this is 0, let's say negative 4 is here. Negative 4 is not less than negative 4, which means negative 4 is not in the interval. So we make an open point on negative 4. And for values less than negative 4, we would have an arrow to the left. As we move left on the number line, we would approach negative infinity. And this is helpful for writing interval notation. We'll have negative infinity to negative 4. It doesn't include negative 4. So we have a rounded parenthesis here, as well as on negative infinity. Looking at our next example, remember a fraction bar represents division. So we can read this x divided by negative 2 is greater than negative 1. So to undo this division, we'll have to multiply both sides of the inequality by negative 2. And since we are multiplying by a negative, we will have to reverse the inequality symbol. Let's go ahead and put this over 1, and now we can see these negative 2's are going to simplify out. So we're left with x. Reversing the inequality, we'll have less than, and then negative 1 times negative 2 is positive 2. So there's our solution as an inequality. We'll go ahead and graph this. So if this is 0, maybe this is 2. Since x is less than 2, not equal to 2, 2 is not in this interval. So we have an open point on 2, arrow to the left, approaching negative infinity. So using interval notation, we have negative infinity and 2. It doesn't include 2, so we have a rounded parenthesis here, as well as on negative infinity. Looking at the next example, we have x minus 9 is greater than or equal to negative 12. So to solve this for x, we'll add 9 to both sides. This would be 0, so we have x is greater than or equal to negative 12 plus 9 is negative 3. So x is greater than or equal to negative 3. And because this interval does include negative 3, we'll have a close point on negative 3. And then for numbers greater than negative 3, we have an arrow to the right approaching positive infinity. So using interval notation, we have negative 3 comma infinity. Since it includes negative 3 or is closed on negative 3, we have a square bracket here and a rounded parenthesis here. I think we have time for two more. We have 7x is greater than negative 7. These two are attached by multiplication. So to solve for x, we'll divide both sides by 7. We're dividing by a positive, so we do not reverse the inequality symbol. So here we'd have x is greater than negative 1. That's our solution as an inequality. So if this is 0, maybe this is negative 1. We'd have an open point on negative 1 because this interval does not include negative 1, and then arrow to the right. Again, approaching positive infinity. So using interval notation, we have negative 1 comma infinity, rounded parenthesis here and here. I think we'll go ahead and stop here because we did this problem on the previous screen. Okay, I hope you found these examples helpful.